In this video, I'm going to show you how you could convert a PDF file into an Excel file. I have this PDF file here, and I'm just using Adobe Acrobat Reader, which is a free Adobe software that you could just download for Mac or PC. So I have this PDF file, and now in order to take this PDF file into an Excel file, I'm going to show you a couple of different ways to do that. Now let me show you the way I do it, which is not using an Acrobat Reader. So here's that same PDF file. I'm just going to click on it. I'm going to say open with Adobe Acrobat, not Acrobat Reader, which is free. Adobe Acrobat is part of the Adobe Creative Suite that I have here. So it is a paid software by Adobe, but I'm going to show you a free way to do it. It's a little bit more work, so if you're going to do this often, it's best to get Adobe Acrobat. If you have Adobe Acrobat, all you do is go to File, Export, and right there you could just export it to Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, even PowerPoint. So if I just press that right here, Excel worksheet, and I'm just gonna name this copy so I don't get it confused with the other files. I'm gonna just press save, and it's exporting right there. And right now it just opened it in Excel for me, so I'll just maximize it. There's just a few problems with it, but nothing major. There's just a little bit of spacing problem here, and I could edit any of these numbers as I need to right here in Excel. So now with the free option, let me go ahead and just close this Excel document, and I'm gonna close Adobe Acrobat Pro right here, and I'll just go back to Adobe Reader here with the same file. Now if I go to File, I don't have that same export setting. I could do Word or Excel online, but that just takes me to the Adobe website. For example, right here, if I say export as Excel and I press export, it basically takes me to a place where I could buy Adobe Acrobat Pro, which is what I already have, and that is how I convert it. There's a few cheaper options. Convert existing PDF into Microsoft Word, Excel, if that's all you're using it for. Obviously Adobe Acrobat has a lot more options, but if you don't want to do this and this is a one-time deal that you're dealing with, I'm going to show you how to do that right now. I'm just going to close this page and it's going to take me back to my file. So this is another way to do it. You could basically just highlight all the fields. Now don't select everything at once. Just grab your columns and select them just like this by dragging your mouse, and go ahead and copy. I'm just on a Mac here, so I'm control clicking. Just press copy here, or you could go to edit copy and go ahead and copy this. And now I'm gonna go ahead and go to Excel. I'm just gonna create a new worksheet here in Excel, and in my new worksheet, I wanna just select the cell where I'm gonna paste, and I'm just gonna go ahead and control click here and paste. Again, you could just come up here and do a paste that way. So now as you could see, the formatting is completely off, so this is really not gonna help me. It did bring all the information, but this is gonna be so much more work than the process I just showed you a second ago, and that was a much easier process. But to change this formatting is actually not that hard. So in order to change this formatting, all you have to do is go to Data, and you wanna click Text to Column, or you could go up here, Text to Column. And if you're on a PC, you should just be able to see the same setting. So if you press Text to Column, you wanna do a little bit of work right here. So I'm just gonna pick the first option here, press Next. And now if you check different things, you'll see the formatting change a little bit. So in this case, I want space to be the option selected. See, if I do it, it shows me a preview here. So if I had Tab, it's not doing anything. So space is the option I want based on the formatting on my PDF. I'm gonna press Next, and then I'm just gonna press Finish here. And as you could see, now we're a lot closer to what Adobe Acrobat got us, but there is a few issues here that we'll need to adjust. If you look here, some of the columns have shifted over. There's a couple of words that should have been on this column, they went over there. So all I gotta do is select those and delete. And then if I say Shift Cell Left, in this case, it's gonna put everything back in order. And then I could type in whatever I need to here that I just deleted. So I could either copy this and put it here, if I just reshape this. So it's done it over here again. I could just go to Delete, Shift Left. You see that is putting everything. Again, it's a lot easier than creating this Excel file from scratch, but it's not perfect. So if you want perfect, get Adobe Acrobat. And I do have to warn you, there are free softwares that claim that they would do this for you online. But if you have sensitive and private information that you don't want to share and just have up there in the cloud, it's best to either do it this way or get Adobe Acrobat, which is a secure and respectable software, instead of using some sort of online website to do this and they'll have your file basically stored. So I personally rather do Adobe Acrobat and just skip this process of formatting. But if you really are doing this very rarely, once a while, just go ahead and do it this way and just finish up any formatting errors. I hope this was helpful. Please go ahead and give us a like and comment if you have any issues. And I hope to see you again here for any tech-related how-to videos and a lot more. Thanks for watching.